I was in LA a little while ago, and they have a thing in bars, like just pubs in LA. They have a thing called a drink minimum policy. They might have it here in Canada too. I don't know. It's where you have to have a minimum of two drinks if you go into the pub. I don't know why. The big bouncer, sir, we have a two-drink minimum policy. I said, that won't be a problem. So long as there's no maximum, let the games begin. And I went into this pub, and I got up to the bar. I was sitting on the bar stool, making friends, you know, having a few drinks. But here's the thing: they don't have in bars in America, they don't have that nice little safety bit at the back of the stool. It's just a flat stool, you know, like, because that's handy. In Scotland, you get that and you're telling a story. And I said to him, and then, oh, oh, fuck.
Nearly went back there, didn't I?
But they don't have it in America. I didn't know this. And I was telling a story and I was having a bit of a laugh. And then I went to drink the last bit of my beer. And I had to tilt my head all the way back. And I went, oh, shit, wait, this isn't right. And I went all the way back. And I fell off my bar stool. Now, there's two reactions to falling off your bar stool, right? You either laugh like a child on the ground, encouraging people to join in. Ah, 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 ah. I have fallen. Ha, 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 ha. Blood pouring out the back of your head. That's the first reaction. Well, the other reaction is you get straight back up. You've got to get straight back up now and take a long, hard look at the stool. That is dangerous. I did the first one, right? Lying on the ground, laughing away. The big bouncer, the big, you know, two drink minimum guy comes up to me. Huge guy. He had his mobile phone in a holster. Don't move or I'll text you. Sir, he said, I'm gonna have to ask you to leave. I says, why? Why would you do that? That's my drunk voice, by the way. Do you ever do that when you're drunk? Do you ever over enunciate? Because in your head, you think, if I'm talking like that, how will anybody know I've been drinking? Because, you know, like, I'm talking normally and all that. Hello, I'd like to get into the club, please. You don't know me.
It's one of the things I love about Scotland is our drinking. We go nuts. You can tell how much a country loves its drinking from its reaction to last orders at the bar, can't you? Last call, you know, that little bell, ding, 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 ding. In Paris, they're all cool and, we're at his last orders. We should finish up our drinks and go outside into the moonlight. It will be very beautiful. I will kiss you. But in Scotland, we go nuts. Ding, ding, fucking bang up, you bastard, fuck off, you fucking, don't you dare ring that fucking bell, you fucking fuck. There's no one. It's crazy. Never. No one. Here's the thing. No one ever wants to go home in Scotland. Well, I don't want to go home now. I'll remember everything. What was the point in coming out? But last call in Scotland, of course, means you don't have to go. You don't have to go there. You can get one more drink in. But we're Scottish, so we get two in. That's what we always do, right? We've only got 15 minutes left, right? Two, come on, everyone, two, two. Come on, two. Fuck off, you're having two. Two, 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 two. Everyone's got to fuck off, you're having two, mate. You know, you can be hunched on the toilet, puking your guts out. And come on, get it out, you're having two. Come on. And it's not uncommon. See, it's not uncommon in Scotland to see a guy at the end of the night with a drink in each hand. Sometimes we've got a drink in between the two. Doesn't matter. It's just the way we, because, you know, we don't need our hands. You'd never see that in Italy. You'd never see a guy with a drink in each hand. How would he talk?